And I love this expression of co-authoring experiences, is looking at Malcolm X's connection to the Arab world. And in that, I discovered Malcolm's relationship to Palestine. And I don't know if anybody in the room knows or has heard of Malcolm X's trip to Gaza. Show of hands, anybody? That's great, I'm in an enlightened room, thank you very much. The interesting story about that trip is what came out of that trip for Malcolm X. So I'm going to tell you a little bit about that. I worked on this biography on Malcolm X called Life of Reinvention. Folks might disagree with it, we can have a talk about that later. But I looked at Malcolm X's travels in the Middle East in 64. So he traveled around the Middle East and North Africa in 64 for a total of 24 weeks. And during his second trip in the summer of 64, he attended it, he went all over the place. He was in Egypt because the Organization of African Unity was having their second annual conference in Egypt. And because he was there, he ended up going to the Arab Summit, which was having their conference in Alexandria. So as I'm reading the story, I find in his diaries a poem, a stanza from a poem. What's interesting is that the author of this poem, which I'm going to read you the stanza, is somebody I had never heard of before. So while Sameh Al-Qasim is incredibly popular, this poet, very few Palestinians I've spoken to remember him. So this is what was written in Malcolm X's diaries. We must return. No boundaries should exist. No obstacles can stop us. Cry out, refugees. We shall return. Tell the mountains, we shall return. Tell the alley, we shall return. We are going back to our youth. Palestine calls us to arm ourselves, and we are armed, and we are going to fight. We must return. So this is Malcolm dictating what he heard, and it turns out this poet is named Harun Hashim Rashid, and Malcolm met him on a two-day trip, thank you so much, on a two-day trip to Gaza, which was September 5th, 1964, to September 6, 1964. And he ended up having dinner with a colonel, and then at night, he's sitting with Harun Hashim Rashid. Harun Rashid tells him the story about his escape from Gaza in 1956 during the Khan Yunis massacre. And the Khan Yunis massacre happens in 1956. Over 600 people are killed. I just want to get the numbers correct. Huge refugee movement. And at this time, Egypt is also in 64 in control of Gaza. That's why Malcolm could go in and out. And what's interesting is on the next page in his diary entry, he lists the details of the Khan Yunis massacre. And then on the following page of the Khan Yunis massacre, Malcolm starts to theorize about indigeneity and colonialism. So he has this list that he writes, and he says, Spain, Moroccans, America, Indians, Negroes, Africa, Arabs, indigenous to Palestine, Israelis from Europe. And then at the bottom he says, colonialism, imperialism, Zionism equals racism. And literally 11 days later, he publishes a piece in the Egyptian Gazette, which is called Zionist Logic. And this is an incredible op-ed. It's very easily accessible online. If you just write Zionist Logic, you can find it. But most people don't know the story of how this came to be and where Malcolm X's politics came from. And it came from my estimation is that it came from this encounter he had with Harun Hashim Rashid. Because you see the political development in his diaries, and then I can give you some quotes from Zionist Logic so you can see the relationship that he ends up making. He says, he calls Zionism 20th century dollarism. And he says this new kind of Zionist colonialism differs only in form and method, but never in motive or objective. Another quote, if the Israeli Zionists believe their present occupation of Arab Palestine is the fulfillment of predictions made by their Jewish prophets, then they must also religiously believe that Israel must fulfill its divine mission to rule all other nations with a form of irons, which only means a different form of iron-like rule, more firmly entrenched even than that of former European colonial powers. So he goes hard. The other famous quote attributed to Malcolm actually shows up in this op-ed. And he says, they cripple the bird's wing and then they condemn it for not flying as fast as they. So here he's talking about the way that Arabs are represented via Palestine, via being developing countries in the third world struggle. Why, he's asking the question, why African leaders wouldn't want to invest in the Arab world because of the way that they've been crippled by this kind of colonialism. And so it's an amazing op-ed. But what I find more amazing is Malcolm's reaction to poetry. So this is another part of the story that people don't know, that Malcolm actually, from looking at his prison diaries in the 1940s, he appeared to have to be moved very strongly by poetry. So he opened some of his prison diaries with his prison letters to his brother Filbert with quotes from Hafez. Very important in the history of Islamic poetry, and Omar Khayyam. Yeah, it's kind of interesting. And you wouldn't even know because he actually just sometimes quotes it and doesn't attribute it, and I know that's another part of the story that we're talking about in prison, because there's a lot of, this is an interesting sort of overlap, there's a lot of recording down without attribution. So I just wanted to offer you this to kind of think about the power of poetry in our political organizing work and our theorizing work as well. And just to, hopefully I'm going to have the longer version of this piece in an article soon so that you can kind of see the theoretical ramifications of this story. So thank you.